Okay, design for shaft. So what is shaft? Shaft is a rotating machine element. Okay, generally use it to transmit power from one location to another location. Okay, so how to design a shaft? Okay, how to solve the shaft problems? Okay, so I suggest you to you have to remember three basic formulas. Okay, to design any shaft. Okay, so what are those? So basic formulas to design to solve any shaft problem. The first formula, power transmitted by shaft. So P is equal to 2 pi mp by 60 watts. First formula. Okay. And second formula, the relation between torque and shear stress. So torque and shear stress, okay, shear stress. Tau is equal to 16t by pi d cube, 16t by pi d cube. And the final formula, torsion equation, very popular equation, torsion equation. What is the torsion equation? E by J is equal to G theta by L is equal to tau by R. Okay, where T is torque and tau is shear stress. Okay, these are the basic formulas. Okay, so these three formulas are enough. Okay, to solve any shaft problem, basic problems related to design of a shaft. Okay. Let us solve one example, simple example. Okay, fine. Okay, now let us see one problem. Okay, a shaft running at 400 rpm transmits 10 kilowatt power. Assuming allowable shear stress in shaft is 40 MPa, find the diameter of the shaft. Okay, fine. So here, what? First of all, as usual, given data. What is the given data? Okay. Please write down the given data. So what is the given data here? So shaft running at 400 rpm. So 400 rpm. So revolution per minute means speed. So rpm means speed. Unit for speed. N is equal to 400 rpm. Okay. Speed. Next. And it transmits 10 kilowatt power. Okay, 10 kilowatt means power, unit of power watt. So 10 kilowatt. So power 10 kilowatt. So power. So given some power, P is equal to 10 kilowatt. It can be rewritten as 10 into 10 cube. 1 kilowatt is equal to 10 cube. Okay, 10 cube watts. Okay. Next. And again, allowable shear stress 40 MPa. So here the allowable shear stress. So allowable shear stress is also given. Shear stress. Tau is equal to 40 MPa. So here allowable shear stress is 40 MPa. This is this is the given data. Okay. So what we need to find here? We need to find the diameter of the shaft. Okay. So diameter of the shaft. So here unknown is diameter of the shaft. Diameter of the shaft. D is equal to small d. Let us say small d. So small d is our unknown. Okay. Now, first step. What is the first step to solve any shaft problem? Okay. So here we have a term power. Okay, here we have the variables power and speed. Okay, now use that power formula. POWR, power. P is equal to, what is the formula for power? The power transmitted by shaft. So fundamental formula, 2 pi mt by 60. 2 pi mt by 60. Here the only unknown is torque. Here T, capital T denotes, indicates torque transmitted by a shaft. So we can calculate the torque. Okay, then P means 10 into 10 cube means 10 power 4 watts is equal to 2 into pi into n. What is n? Speed. So how much? 400. Okay. Into t divided by 60. Okay. Divided by 60. Okay. After rearranging these terms, t becomes, t is equal to, let us take all these terms to the left hand side, 10 power 4 into 60 divided by 2 into pi into 4. Now, calculate this expression, okay, then we will get that final answer is 238.73 Newton meter. So unit for torque is Newton meter. So 238.73 Newton meter. So here we got torque. Okay. So again, so this is actually the first formula. Power. This is actually the first formula. Okay. You need to remember while solving shaft problems. Okay. Now, so we have torque. Okay. Here we have torque. And also shear stress is also given. Okay, so there is a relation between torque and shear stress. Yes or no? There is a relation. What is the relation? Just we discussed earlier. What is the relation? Tau is equal to shear stress. Tau is equal to 16T by pi d cube. 16T by pi d cube. Where D is the diameter of the shaft. And T is the torque transmitted by shaft. And tau is the allowable shear stress. Then from this relation we can get that we can calculate that diameter of the shaft. Okay. So shear stress tau is equal to 16T by pi d cube. Okay. Now from this relation d cube is equal to, so what is d cube? D cube is equal, let us take d cube to the left hand side. D cube is equal to 16T by pi tau. Okay, again d is equal to, again d is equal to, diameter of shaft d is equal to 16 capital T by pi into tau whole to the power of 1 by 3. Okay, here we have cube. Okay, so whole to the power of 1 by 3. Okay. Now substitute 16 is equal to, what is the tau, T value? 238.73 into, let us convert that Newton meter to Newton mm. Okay, convert into Newton meter to Newton mm. Okay, so if you want to convert Newton meter to Newton mm, we simply multiply with 10 cube. Okay, 10 cube, because one meter is equal to 1000 mm. Okay, so it becomes Newton mm, 238.73 Newton mm, and pi into tau. What is the value of tau? 40 MPa. 40 MPa means, you know already, Newton per MPa is equal, 1 MPa is equal to how much? 1 MPa. Remember, units are very important. Okay. 1 MPa is equal to 10 power 6 Pascal. Okay. Or 10 power 6 Newton per meter square. Again, it can be written as 1 Newton per mm square. 1 Newton per mm square. 40 MPa means 40 Newton per mm square. Okay, here shear stress is in Newton per mm square. Also, the torque is also in Newton mm. Okay, same, we are maintaining same units. Okay, uniformity. So, uniformity, we are maintaining uniformity in units. Okay, fine. Now, the D becomes whole power 1 by 3. Okay, upon solving, after solving this expression, okay, the diameter of D is equal to, you will get 31.2 mm. 31.2 mm. Hence, diameter of the shaft. Small d is equal to 31.2 mm. The final answer. Okay, is it okay? So simple procedure. Okay. You just need to remember that power formula, P is equal to 2 pi nt by 60, and the relation between torque and shear stress, okay, tau is equal to 16 t by pi d cube, and also torsion equation, t by g is equal to g theta by l is equal to tau by r. Okay, a shaft can be designed based on strength and based on rigidity. Based on strength means we consider that maximum torque transmitted by a shaft, Whereas based on rigidity means we consider that rigid shear modulus that and that angle of twist. Okay, relation. We consider the torsion equation relation. Okay, torsion equation. Okay, fine. This is a procedure to simple procedure to solve any shock.